I could ride y'all up to sundown.
I like to ride because it's the nicest feeling in the world.
I rode in the rain and loved it just as much as I loved riding in the sun.
It's a lot of camaraderie for one thing. A lot of motorcycles.
Fucking people watch is awesome. The bikes are awesome. People are friendly.
Kind of like a peace of mind. Relax. Forget about the world, kind of.
They come from all walks of life and from city streets and country roads all across the nation and around the world. Each face is uniquely different. They're young and old, male and female too. Hardcore and laid back, they ride choppers and cruisers and sport bikes. All are united by one common interest. All are driven by one desire. They ride.
I would say it's not really a sensation of being afraid.
It can be an exhilarating, almost scary sensation a lot of times with an adrenaline rush.
Galveston, Texas, a beautiful island bordering the Gulf of Mexico. It boasts sandy beaches and famous 19th century architecture, and quite a few seagulls. And once a year, a flock of another kind invades its shores. As a multitude of bikers cruise in from all over the United States and the world to attend the Lone Star Motorcycle Rally.
I read one time, which is that there's no problem big enough that a full tank of gas and a sunny day can't fix. So a lot of times that's what riding does for me. You know, you have groups that just ride together and have a great time. Then you have motorcycle clubs like the one I belong to, which we do exactly the same thing, but it's kind of on a little different scale. We, from the club perspective, we look out for each other.
I could ride from sunup to sundown, stopping occasionally. The furthest I've ever ridden in one day is probably 600 miles, maybe 800. I never put a number on it. That's part of the freedom. You don't look at the miles, you don't look at the time. I don't wear a watch. It's irrelevant. As a kid, I always wanted to ride, since I was a little kid, I guess. Just for the sheer, just being free, having fun, open road.
It's awesome. It's peaceful. It's calming. You compare it to how a dog that hangs its head out the window. That's the fun of it.
I just love the freedom of the road, being by yourself, playing your thoughts. It's a nice way to travel and camaraderie with everybody that gets together and rides together. Got a bunch of friends that ride together. We all go and do things.
The feeling is kind of hard to describe. I don't know. It's just open air. Nothing pressing. Relaxed. The wind on your face. The smells as you're going through different parts of the country, you smell things that are different, like flowers or wheat or hay or whatever. And it's just a real nice experience. It's kind of like going down the road in the car with a pop down, I guess.
My father rides and my uncles ride, so I was destined to ride. It's a lot of freedom. You feel like you can smell everything around you. You can hear everything around you. You definitely don't feel like you're protected. You feel more like you're more out there and in nature.
Mm-hmm. riding because I like the freedom and I like the different smells of the atmosphere, and it's just awesome. I enjoy it.
I've been trying to go to every bike rally in Texas. So, you know, just get away a little while, have some time for myself, and chill out with the guys, you know, and ride around. That's what it's all about. My dad's been riding for over 50 years, and he has nothing but Harleys. And so we kind of grew up with that mentality of, you know, one day we get older, you know, get a Harley just like my dad. And I got five brothers, and they all have bikes.
I expect a lot of camaraderie, for one thing. A lot of motorcycles, a lot of sights to see, a lot of things to buy, a lot of vendors, a lot of various vendors. They sell everything from leather to jewelry, and again, great food, but just a lot of nice people. It's just a fun time. The travels part of it, the traveling to and from is, for us, is a large part of it. We really enjoy that part of it. So.
Hang out, look at parts. Motorcycles, hang out with people that enjoy the same sort of thing you do. That's pretty much all I mess with anymore is motorcycles. I don't even do with car shows anymore, none of that stuff. I do motorcycles and ride. So, just hangs out with people like yourself. It's an adrenaline rush. It's like a good high. Being free, get out and do what you want to. Ride.
I've been riding since 2002.
What got you into riding?
Real generic. Met a guy that owned a bike and he broke a date, and we bought my own bike. So now I can ride and I don't need another guy to ride.
I go to motorcycle rallies to hang out with friends, enjoy a good crazy time, see all different types of bikes, all different types of people from all over the country. It's fun.
Galveston Rally is one of the biggest ones in this area. It's definitely bigger than ROT, but you're on the coast. Everybody's just friendly, happy, just wild, crazy. Like to drink, have a good time, don't worry about anything, and let your spirits fly.
Besides seeing all the bikes and getting ideas, it's a lot of fun just to see friends. I mean, you run into people you know, and likewise other clubs that you don't normally get to see. It's just nice to be here in a community of all the same kind of people.
We like the people watch. The people watch is awesome. The bikes are awesome. People are friendly. You put anybody on a bike, usually it's all good times. You don't worry about anything, and just ride and have a good time.
We'll be right back. I've been riding since I was 15, 32 years. I've been here like three times.
Why do you go to rallies?
For the fun, the partying, a bunch of our friends go, we all meet up, ride down to the rallies and stuff like that.
The minute you get on the bike, you forget about everything else. It just clears your mind, it's very peaceful. It's just something awesome.
The Lone Star Rally is becoming more popular than ever in this harbor town, and attendees are growing in number by leaps and bounds. This is the eighth year, and over 100,000 bikers made the journey to Galveston Island to revel in the camaraderie of the rally.
Hey, 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 hey.
The Lone Star Rally is the third largest biker rally in the U.S. and is enjoyed by all types of riders.
Oh my God! We're having a wonderful time.
We are.
What do you like about this?
All the bikes.
Of course. Listen to it, the noise.
And the naked ladies.
Well, maybe.
The boys like those a lot.
Choppers, cruisers, sport bikes, and trikes flood the strip in Galveston.
When I was a teenager, I had choppers back in them days, and then as my kids' responsibilities came more expensive, I had to do that. Now they're gone, and now we're able to do the Harley stuff.
We come down to the rally every year. We're down here. We've been coming, I guess the first 2 years we missed it, but we've been here ever since.
I love this rally.
What's so great about it?
Hey, the people.
Why?
Why? Because of the attitude. I mean, everybody. Everybody's got a different attitude. Everybody's mad.
My husband and I are in the Christian Motorcycle Association, and we're active with them. We have a new chapter in Ruidoso, New Mexico, where we live.
My name is Pastor Sam Sassman, and I'm with the Tribe of Judah Motorcycle Ministry, AKA Slammin' Sam. Our function is to make sure that everybody knows that heaven is real and hell is real. And that's why we're here, to spread the gospel. And young lady, do you know that Jesus loves you too?
That's all you need to know. Jesus is Lord.
That's right.
Their style, what they, you know.
I like the sound, the people, they're friendly people, it's absolutely wonderful. Bikers are nice people, and we just enjoy the fellowship.
90% of the bikers are very friendly. They'll do anything to help you. Of course, in every crowd, there's a few bad ones, but I found that most of them are real friendly, they're real helpful, they'll do anything to help you if you get in a bind.
Motorcycle rallies, every year that they have, they are very fun. And I like to come to them because there's so much here to buy, you know what I'm saying, so many different things at the motorcycle rally. People to meet a lot of them.
To me, I come to this rally because I get to meet new people. And I get to see what's things that's out here. You know, it's kind of like an experience for me.
Thanksgiving and happy Halloween.
The best way to describe it is total, complete freedom. I'd have to say I feel at most one with everything. You get on the back of the bike and you don't think about your life or anything else because you're just so enthralled with everything that's going on. It doesn't matter how long I have to be on the back of the bike. It doesn't matter if it's wet. I've rode in the rain and loved it just as much as I loved riding in the sun. It doesn't bother me when it's cold because you're still feeling things different. It's the closest that you could possibly be to God, in my opinion.
Well, I like to ride because it's the nicest feeling in the world. It's the nicest way of seeing places. I've been riding since I was about 15, which is 45 years. I've been come over to America to ride around in the sunshine, all the way from England. Fantastic place to ride.
Exhilarating. Fun. Top notch. It's basically how I can put it. It's very fun.
Freedom.
Freedom?
Freedom is the
word. Yeah, it's mental therapy.
There ain't no bikes in front of a psychiatrist's office.
Oprah and Dr. Phil can't fix you.
Well, the bike can.
It's a rush. Wind in your face. It's some more risk than a car because there's nothing around you to protect you but air and God.
It is a wonderful feeling, carefree, independence, confidence, and I look good.
The wind is your friend.
The wind is your friend.
Said, oh my God, how is it?
Dangerous curves.
Just outside of Houston, Texas is Alvin's Bar. It's a hole in the wall where bikers come to relax, hang out, and drink some beer.
I've been riding since I was probably about 10 years old. I started out on dirt bikes. Whenever I was a baby, my dad used to ride me around on the gas tank to put me asleep. My mom's got pictures of it and stuff, instead of riding me around in a car. So that's how I went to sleep when I was a baby, and then I started riding dirt bikes. And then after that, whenever I got old enough, I wanted a bike. So he went and bought me a bike, and me and him rode together. Now he don't ride no more, but I still ride.
What do you ride?
I've got a Honda Shadow 750. Whenever you ride, it's just kind of like therapy, so that way you get a nice, relaxing, all the little stress just kind of blows away, and you don't have to worry about it, you just have fun and relax. I love going to the rallies because it's the one place you can get together with a group of friends, and you can do whatever you want, nobody cares, and you don't have to worry about anything at all.
Started 20 years ago back in the service when I was in the Navy. Just kind of like a way to get away. Kind of like a peace of mind. Relax. Forget about the world, kind of.
I have been a passenger on a motorcycle for at least 20 years. Started off on the back of my daddy's bike and moved up from there. It's peaceful. It's after a really stressful week to get on the back of a bike and just ride. It's amazing. When I first rode a motorcycle with my dad, I was between the age of 5 and 8. He would just take us for short little rides around the block, and it was super special, super fun. And if we got to go any further than that, we felt really special. He would that was kind of a treat. We would maybe go spend the night at a friend's house, and Dad would come pick us up on the motorcycle, and it was just like our time. And it was fun.
I guess the first time I was on the back of a bike is when my dad got his Honda, and I was probably about 5. And then my mom made him get rid of it because she was scared he was going to kill himself. It was really great. It was awesome being on the back of my dad's bike, or on the front, because he usually set me in between his legs in the front of the bike because I was so little. It made my love for bikes grow immensely.
I guess my first ride was actually a four-legged ride. It was a quarter horse Arabian mix. Then I graduated to motorcycles. I used to drive taxi. Before that, I was a stripper back in the days of burlesque. And I met the vice president of a chapter in Morgan City, Louisiana. And we hit it off. Actually, some hard leg was bothering me to dance, and I went over and crawled up in his lap, and I said, look, I just told this guy you were my husband. He won't leave me alone. He saw your big, mean biker look, and he did an about face and walked away and left me alone. And that night I crawled on the back of his bike and stayed there for several months.
Hi, I'm Jimmy Cash. I've been racing for 3 years and riding for 39, and I'm at the Eagles Canyon track. Today we're at what you typically call a track day. It's open to the public. There's various levels. There's everything from beginner street riders to racers like me that are out practicing. You get in a situation, the adrenaline rush you'll get is when, there's two ways. There's just the adrenaline of accomplishment that you've set a bet your personal best lap time, or you've passed someone, and then there's the adrenaline rush where you've pushed your limits almost too far, and you've recovered from that and come out of it. Being on the racetrack involves a lot of physical endurance and mental endurance. You have to be totally focused on what you're doing, and you have to be physically capable of keeping up with the bike. The thing that I love about the motorcycle community, and especially the racing environment, is everyone is out to help you. It's a very personal style of racing. You have to rely on the guy next to you to do his job so that you both don't get in trouble. You're always out helping each other and giving each other a hand, and it's a great place to make long-term lasting friendships.
I'm Ty Howard, race motorcycles professionally. I also teach Ride Smart and Skip Barber Racing School.
This track here at Eagles Canyon in just north of Decatur is a very nice track. The layout is probably one of the most technical tracks in the country. It's got multiples of blind corners. It's I think 2.8 miles long. It's got numerous straightaways that you can get to top gear on these motorcycles. And it offers a wide variety of corners, unlike most tracks that are kind of cookie cutter. ECR also has a couple different asphalt and cement patches, so that keeps you on your toes a little bit too. Even though they got great traction, it's still a variation of adhesion that you feel. I started on mini bikes when I was 4 years old and gradually worked my way up and began racing dirt bikes around 8 years old. Got a little more serious when I was becoming a teenager, and I switched over to road racing when I was 17. I've been road racing ever since, and so I've been a professional for right at 18 years now, 19 years. So I've been doing it for a long time, and it's basically the only way I've ever made a living. Riding motorcycles is very very dangerous, and if you don't respect your motorcycle and everybody you ride with, you could get injured very badly. Therefore, I recommend anybody getting started in it seek instruction before they try to exceed their limits.
I ride for the adrenaline rush, the thrill of the pucker factor. Come into a corner at 130 miles an hour and you're saying, oh shit, am I gonna stop or not? That's the rush, and that's why I race. I got into racing, club racing, in 2008, and came from local street racing and started losing a lot of friends. Deaths on the street, and you know, I got a wife and kids, and I was looking for a safer way to go out and ride balls to the wall. Now, the majority of the biker communities that I know of are all very, you know, friendly, family oriented. Like to you know, get to know a lot of people.
Hello, my name is Jason Hutchison. I've been riding sport bikes for about 2 years now. A buddy of mine that I work with, I was selling a car, and he was a Ducati enthusiast, so he insisted I buy the motorcycle, and I bought that Ducati Monster, and I had it for about a year, and then I bought a 96 Supersport. Street bikes I've been riding 2 years. I started, of course, as a kid, I rode dirt bikes and hurt myself a lot. You know, it's motorcycles is, I guess it's like any other group, but once you have a common bond with people, and so you just, you know, you find people that have similar interests, so you just hang out, and it really is a great time, just hanging out with friends.
I would say it's not really a sensation of being afraid. Sometimes you get a little bit more excited than the other times, but, you know, I suppose since I have been racing for 30 years now, I kind of got over the whole being scared thing. I guess when I was younger, under 10 or so, it was probably a little bit spooky at times when stuff happened. But now it's just something you're just used to. You know that eventually you're going to fall. It's not really a question of how bad you're going to fall or anything like that. It's just when. You know, and a lot of the crashes are very slow, low sides, which aren't a big deal. But then sometimes you get into a pretty good tangle, and you don't get to slide. You can do a little flipping, and then you kind of get a little worried that whether or not you got hurt or not when you stop. And usually 9 times out of 10, you're okay.
Now let's switch gears and leave the high speed of the racetrack and cruise Route 66 right through the desert of Hackberry in northwestern Arizona.
I'm Fred Wood with the Route 66 Riders, and we're in Hackberry, Arizona on Route 66. The club is primarily a club that's interested in getting riding enthusiasts together, and we stress safety. We like to ride safe and not drink while you ride and that sort of thing. We have about 90 members and usually have 15 or 20 on our rides. It goes right through Kingman where I live. Most of us live there, and it's really a fun highway to ride. One of my favorite rides is from Kingman to up to Seligman, and we like to stop here at Hackberry. John, that owns this Hackberry store, is always a fun guy to stop and see, and we stop at Peach Springs and maybe at the canyons, and just makes a nice day of it. Not a lot of traffic, but you can have a lot of fun out here riding Route 66.
We did 40,000 miles in a year on motorcycles. We just came back from being in Oregon. We rode up Highway 1 up through California, up through Oregon, Washington, went over to Idaho, come back through Nevada. We both like riding. We enjoy each other's company. We're some of the, in the group of motorcycle riders that belong to the club of Route 66, we are a couple of the older riders, but not the oldest. We have some current riders in their 80s that ride with us, and they ride on Route 66. And Jenny here got her license when she was 73.
Thank you.
And she's had it a number of years. So you can be active at an older age on a motorcycle.
Well, my son always wanted me to ride, and I wouldn't do it. So then after my husband died, and I met up with another gentleman named Walt. So he took me around on his motorcycle, and I came back and I told Walt, if we're gonna ride motorcycles with all your health problems, that's the way we're gonna go. And I've been riding ever since. That's about 7 years ago. We had an older bike, and then we had problems with it, so we sold that and got this one that I have right here. It's a 96. And I've got about 67,000 miles on it. So it's been a lot of fun, very enjoyable.
I'm Lisa Boyd. I'm the detailer at Motopia Cafe. Motopia has a garage that we service and maintain bikes. We'll have people schedule an appointment to come in, and I'll clean the bike, look it over good. We've got a 9-point inspection system that we use to make sure the bike goes back out in a roadworthy condition. Principally, that's my job is doing the bike detailing and work. What I do. It's a neat thing. I feel very strongly about motorcycling and riding safely and all of that, so it's a neat thing for me. It's also a relaxed environment that is very enjoyable. I get to meet a lot of different people, and it's a really neat experience. So I started riding later in life. My background is actually in motorsports. I started racing at the club level, the amateur level, SCCA. And I got a lot of experience doing that, raced for 13 years, won the Southwest Division in 1998. And once I retired from the racing scene, I got into motorcycles. And so once I got involved with that, I kind of never looked back. Sold my race car and have been working on motorcycles and riding pretty much nonstop.
Close this thing. Okay. Sit down.